See this EV behind me? I'm gonna kill it. Kill the battery, that is. Ever wonder what happens when the battery gets to 0%? Let's see what happens when your electric car dies on the side of the road. Hey everybody, I'm Desola from Edmunds, where we're known as the car testing pros. Now we've teamed up with the experts over at CarMax to help you find the right car for your needs. This EV currently has 19% of its charge, which is approximately 46 miles. Now that's pretty low, but it's not zero. So we all know what's gonna eventually happen. The battery will run out and the car will stop. But what about before that? Do you even have enough time to stop safely? And what happens after the battery dies and you're stuck on the side of the road? And does the car even warn you before any of that happens? So right now I'm cruising at about 40 miles per hour and I'm really keeping my eye on everything and the warnings that are popping up and all that to see what it looks like. The car does do a really good job at notifying you that you are losing range, so you have plenty of time to put your hazard lights on and safely pull over. Also, if you're somebody who is afraid of this, it's kind of like the same way as if you push your gas tank to zero, because I've done that many times, but I always make it. And this is making me believe that you'll make it too. 4 miles of range left. All right, we're getting there. So I have the AC up because it's 105 degrees outside right now. If you can't tell by the way I'm sweating. 3 miles left. Why am I getting excited about this? Okay, 2 miles left. All right, so now the car is reading that we have 0 miles of range left, like really zero. But I'm still going at highway speed, so what's up with that? Just like the gas tank in most gas-powered cars, the battery in a lot of EVs has a little extra wiggle room, allowing it to go a bit farther even if it's reading zero. So I'm resetting the trip right now because I wanna see how many miles I actually get over the 0 mile range. Surprisingly, there's no other notifications or anything going on here except for the 0 miles, of course. But if you see that zero, just know that you're on borrowed time. Also, remember that running your battery this low all the time can actually damage it in the long run. And hey, listen, we're all human. So if it happens from time to time, it's okay. It's not the end of the world. But if you're constantly running your battery to zero without charging it, you'll shorten its life. It's much better to keep it between 20 and 80%. And we have a whole video on why battery degradation happens, and you should definitely check it out. All right, so it's a good thing that I'm on a closed test track right now because the car is losing speed. But the positive is that it's a really gradual thing. So if this happened in the real world, you definitely have more than enough time to put your hazard lights on and pull over. Even when I floor it right now, nothing's happening. I'm still driving. Ooh, wait, okay, hold on. So it's not accelerating past 40 miles, okay. Now, another notification just came up and it said that you can potentially damage your battery and that the battery is too low. Okay, so I just got a notification that says unable to drive, battery charge level too low, but I'm still pushing the accelerator and it's still going. We're 8 miles over the 0 mile range right now. So we just reached 10 miles past the zero range mark. Car still moving, still going good. It does still say unable to drive, but it's obviously driving. All right, so I'm going up a hill, which is not the place that you want the car to stop. And this is where it is stopping. Come on, a little farther. I'm pushing it. And boom. Oh, it made a whole noise and everything. All right. I got 15 miles over the 0 mile range mark, which is pretty amazing, but the car has completely stopped. It says pull over safely. I thought that the air conditioner would stay on, but the air conditioner turned off. But if you notice, I still can roll down my windows. I can still use the infotainment system, but it says electrical system is unable to support all features. So we made it, 15 miles over. Now this is where EVs are definitely at a disadvantage compared to gas-powered cars. After all, you can't just buy a bunch of electrons in a can and pour them into the battery. Even mobile charging has been largely abandoned, although AAA is trying it out again in a few areas around the US. Here I am on the side of the road, and if this happened to you, what you'd have to do is call some type of roadside assistance so they can help you take your car to a charging station. But most importantly, it needs to be taken on a flatbed, all right? All four wheels need to be off the ground. Tesla and other EV makers have all pointed out that if you try to tow an EV the same way you tow a gas-powered car, you can damage it. But now the question is, how do you get it onto the tow truck? EV makers have thought of this. On this Tesla, there's a special transport mode, which takes it out of park and allows it to be hauled onto a flatbed tow truck. So look, the reality is that it's actually really hard to completely run an EV's battery empty. Plus, the car gives you tons of heads up before the battery dies. Now, we did this on purpose here at a closed test track, and it took us a while to get to zero. And when it finally did die, compared to a car running out of gas, it's pretty anticlimactic. The biggest downside is really just waiting for the car to recharge. So you might want to keep a good book in the glove box just in case. What questions do you have about EV ownership? Let us know in the comments below. And of course, make sure to let me know which book you'd like to read while you wait for it to charge.